Here, I thought this was my new quiet base. But I'm hearing strange noises. Welcome to Shenaniderp! And yeah, I just logged in and I started hearing this. The noise. It sounds like a zombie pigman is hanging around. And then I went to go outside. 64 by 64 quarries? Oh, damn. Okay, yeah, that's huge. But I went to go outside, and then I saw this. Here is a long-awaited gift. Your travels have taken you far. This will keep you going. Everybody's waiting for one of those MM9Ks. I gotta make one. Later. I'm recording at the moment. But I also saw this. I'm pretty sure it says your buddy Westwoods. It's kinda hard to see from here. Yeah, your buddy Westwoods. Chest. Okay, so it's not what I thought it was. It's a notebook. A notebook. Oh, sweet. That ought to be one of the notebooks with, like, all of the symbols in it. Awesome. I'm gonna go check out. I'm gonna put this back, because this looks awesome. I'm gonna check out that noise, and then I'm gonna go play with that. I would assume the noise is coming from over here. Because that's where the nether portal is. Where are you? But I don't hear him anymore now. What the crap? Hear him. It sounds like he's coming from inside or something. Yeah. Sounds like he's coming from inside my base. Oh, it's just Enderman. He's having some fun down here. The Enderman kind of went ape. Where'd you go? Oh, you went into the water, I guess. I think that's what that noise was. Where are you? Sounds like you're upstairs. Ah! Okay, he died. Okay, he didn't die? Holy crap. Do they just scream randomly now? Because I swear to God, that sounded like he was dying. Quick little bastards. Alright, how about you come out here into the open? Come and get me, buddy boy. He's downstairs. Where you at? He's trying to come out the door. That's hilarious. Okay, problem solved. Alrighty. Well, that was fun. Let's go check out this new present. Okay, so this is the notebook I already have. I don't have many of the symbols. Ha ha ha, now we're talking. Small biome, single biomes, native biome controller, medium biomes, large biomes, huge biomes, checkerboard biomes, tiny biomes. I figured it'd be like an Eternal Day one. But if I remember correctly from playing with Mistcraft in the single player world, Bright is actually too bright. It blinds you if you stand out in the sun. Dark is blindness. And standard lighting is standard. Black sunset? Cool. Some neat stuff. What do they need? War modifiers. Spontaneous explosions. Skylands. Ooh, that's awesome. Meteors. Dense ores. Charged. Accelerated. Yeah. That's a quick way to corrupt your world. I don't know what charged means. Slow time, double time, fast time, eternal night, eternal dusk, eternal day. Sweet! I'll play with that shortly. But, now that I've got all the confusing stuff down... Man, I thought that was a zombie pigment. I was hoping that was a zombie pigment. I gotta go clean up from an Enderman. How many times do you have to say that? You have to go clean up because of an Enderman. It's a lot of dirt. It's like he was hoarding it or something. Goofy. Freaking Enderman. Oy. Oh, hey, I gotta know you matter. That's gonna be something I'd do today. That's divisible by 6, too. That's 4. Later. First things first. One of you guys on the YouTubes, if you give me a second, I'll look up who exactly. A guy named K9504 asked how you make a maze map focus. Alright, and that's what these things are for. They're the maze map focus little token thingies that you get out of chests in the Minotaur maze, or, as I found out recently, they get dropped by the little gnome guys in the Twilight. Well, I have 3 of them, so that's perfect to do what I want. What I would want to do to describe them. The first thing I'm gonna do is actually grab the pieces I need and then head over to the Minotaur maze. I think that's 3 times 9, but that should be enough. So we'll head over to the Minotaur maze, because that's what they were originally designed for. Wait, I'm prepared for this, right? No, I should probably charge up my stuff. Now this will be the same Minotaur maze that I've been dealing with for a little while now. Because I've been in there, I've been taking the blocks from the maze. Boy, that stuff's tough. That stuff's hard to deal with. A large chunk of this building is made out of those stones. Okay, that should be good enough. So let's head over to the Minotaur maze. Oh, I built this a little while ago. I was poking... I had this problem. I had all this creosote oil that was filling up my coke oven, and it was taking up all kinds of glass just to take it out of the coke oven, because once this fills, you can't make any more coke. So I figured I was going to put a bunch of tanks, like the buildcraft tanks, to hold that normally hold lava and water. You could also hold oil in it, and you could hold the creosote oil in it, too. But I was poking around on the Railcraft wiki, and I found this. These are tanks. This block is the tank wall. The tank valve is that one right there, and this one over here. And then... Oh, I forget what they're called. I have a few spare. Iron tank wall, iron tank valve, and iron tank gauge. I don't know why it's called a gauge, it's just glass. But they're made out of these iron plates, which are just 9 iron bars in a 3x3 that go through the rolling machine. And then what you do is you just take the iron tank walls and put them up in a, like, cube type shape, like this, where it's just a frame. And there are limitations to how big they can be and, you know, how tall they can be and all that fun stuff. But this is the basic setup. And then you fill in the areas in the middle of the frame with any combination of the walls, the gauges, or the valves. Now, to use the piping has to go into the valve to put stuff in or pull stuff out. So that's why I have valves. Now we can access stuff directly from anywhere in the tank, but to use the buildcraft pipes, it has to be through the valves. So basically I just have a waterproof wooden pipe coming out of the coal oven, being powered by a redstone engine, into a bunch of waterproof stone pipes, and that just... Once it gets around to it, it's not exactly fast, but it's just a redstone engine. So it's pretty cool that it actually shows the oil flowing in. Okay, I think it's pretty cool. But because it's a redstone engine and because it's attached to a wooden pipe, I could leave this redstone engine running forever and not have a problem. But I tend to just turn it off when it's not in use because, I don't know, I'm weird that way. But I don't really know how to describe how much this can hold. I mean, this holds 64,000 somethings of oil. Yeah, I don't know, 64,000 pounds of oil? I have no idea how they would measure it. Liters? I don't know, liters is a hell of a lot. But 64,000 is 2 stacks of coal that went through this thing. So if you throw 1 stack through, it'll fill it up halfway. And you throw a 2nd stack through, it'll fill it up the rest of the way. And this holds 2 million. Considerable amount of more can be held in this big-ass tank. And since... I'm probably going to have a lot of it because I use the coal coke more often than I use the oil. Yeah. Even though I was playing with Railcraft and it does a lot. Like, a lot. So I'm probably going to be playing with Railcraft a little bit more. This one. I'm forgetting where I'm putting things. Okay, so... This one, okay. do have one. I thought I had one here. Man, I'm running slow today. I wonder why that is. I mean, it's still not bad. I'm recording at 30 frames per second, and it's showing it to me at 60 frames per second, so it's not terrible, but considering it's only two-thirds of what it normally is, it's kind of bad. Okay. Into the maze we go. Alright, now, I've explored a lot of this. Well, this entire first floor, in fact. Before. Now, the reason I'm building this down here in the Risk is because I'm not 100% sure how this works. I'm going to assume that it works like the magic map, where you start out with an empty map. Yeah, blank maze map. Yeah. And then you right-click to activate it. So. Clicky. Now we can see that it's only loading a few gray blocks. And the reason for that is because it's showing us this level. All of the blocks that are on this specific level. So it's actually showing us the maze itself. There we go. Hey, I didn't know you guys spawned down here. Oh man, everything's down here. Let's try to light this place up a bit. Oh, is that a way I didn't go yet? I thought I went everywhere down here. So I'm taking this opportunity to gather up everything that I can. Oh, I did explore here before. Something blew up. And all these things around. Okay. So we can see chests. Because it's color coding. Oh, I went the wrong way. Hey, I can actually see that now. I wanted to go this way. Yeah, let's go here. Okay, we can see the gravel is just covering up a little section in there. It doesn't really matter. Oh, hi, creeper. Whoa! Oi, I didn't expect this to be that hard. I didn't have this much trouble last time I was down here. But yeah, basically this map fills in as you go, and you can see everything that's on this level of blocks. So that way you can make your way through the maze easier. Assuming you know where you're going. I tend not to, as you can see. I tend to get lost. But yeah, this is also very zoomed in, unlike the magic map. This map is zoomed in far enough so that one pixel on the map is one block, which is pretty cool. Ow. Yeesh. So much going on right now. My sword's getting low. I still don't know where the way down is. Well, as far as I can tell, each Minotaur maze has 3 levels. So, to properly search the area, you have to have 3 maps. Yeesh. Well, you didn't show that on the map, did you? Alright, that means the way down must be north of the entrance. But I don't think that matters for the sake of our purpose, or for the sake of our testing. Let's head button back to Black Mesa. What does matter for the sake of our testing is how well this works in caves. I guess it wouldn't work too terribly well, because caves tend to go up and down as well as in and out. But there is one thing. Well, you know what? Let's find out. Before I go into exactly what that does, let's find out how it works. I need... well, a lot of stuff. Block of iron, block of gold. Whoops. My bad. Put all that back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And... now, I wouldn't do this normally because it's diamond, but I want to show you guys how this works. Yeah, that's a lot of diamond. I normally wouldn't do this. But to show you guys how it works, I'll use the diamonds. No, we need a compressor. Because of Greg Tech, we need a compressor. So we got a block of gold, block of iron, block of diamond. Go over here. Take one of our maze map focuses. Now, I don't know if this is going to work. Let's find out. No, apparently not. Alrighty then. Well then, I'm going to do that down in the caves. I'm just going to take this one just for sake of ease. So I'm mildly curious about 2 things that this thing does. I'm curious if it works in the overworld, and I'm curious if what I'm trying to do works all around. Is this where my cave is? Yeah, I think it is. It's been a long time since I've gone caving. I haven't had to. For the most part, I just had my quarry in my Mistcraft world doing its thing. Whee! Closes in. Whee! And then it goes away. Alrighty, so this is the level I want to do this on, because this is level 16. Or is it level 12? I forget. Whatever. So, let's activate this maze map. And yeah, we can see my pathways there, and we can see a very large chunk of the area not explored. So we take my new maze map, we combine it with the gold block, the diamond block, and the iron block, and we got a blank maze slash ore map. Alright, let's activate this again. And now we see not much. But we definitely see different color, like over there, and over there, and straight this way. Oh, I like how it glows like it's enchanted. Alright, basically what's going on is that this color coding here is telling me where all the ores are in the area. So, like, the different colors mean the different types of ores. So it's telling me that there's ore here. Now, it's also going, like, three up and three down. So this is actually more thorough than my cave system. Ah, yes, we're finding iron. Is that what this thing saw? I don't know. It's hard to tell. Well, let's tear it out and see what happens. No, I don't think this is... Oh, maybe that's what it was telling me about. It was telling me about this up here and this down here. Let's see what happens if I tear it out. Does it all go away? No. Ooh, we got gold. Ooh, we got ruby. But we got plenty of ruby, so I'm not worried about silk touch. Let's rip this gold out. Ooh, there we go, okay. That had to have been it. Let's back off so we can see. Okay, and we could see that that area that was right there, the green chunk, is now gone. So, that weird green color is gold. Now, I don't intend on figuring out what each color means, because that would take forever. But how this works with all vanilla ores. And it attempts to work with modded ores, like the silver here. The way it does that it is it looks for the ore in the name, the O-R-E. And if it sees that, it will mark it on the map. So, like, monazite and, what's the other one called? Bauxite. It won't see those, because they're mods. They're mod ores. And, yeah. And they don't have the name ore in them. And bauxite and monazite are from Gregatech, I believe, so they're not Twilight. I have no idea what that is. It's probably the sun. There's probably, like, a cave over there that goes just out of the range of where the chunks are loaded, and the sun happens to be setting at the moment. Or that was the sky. But yeah, that looks exactly what that was. It was the sun. Okay. Well, that was a learning experience. But yeah, that's how the magic maps work. And we can see that I'm above where it will register, so I will have to go mining with this thing here shortly. Take that backpack off. The next thing I want to do is upgrade my solar panels. Yes, I know I'm on advanced solar panels already. Okay, I heard the spider, but apparently. Oh, there he is. He's non-hostile right now. Cool. Alright, but yeah, I'm on advanced solar panels now. But as I showed in my last episode, I have the matter fab plugged directly into them. So this confusing thing right here is plugged directly into the solar panels and my water mills. Now, I know that there is no way that I'm going to take these 12 and number 13 over there and make them output more power than a matter fab can input. Because a matter fab can input power from a lightning rod, which gives you 8192. 8192 EU in one shot. I don't know how well that works. I'll have to play with the lightning rod and find out. But, yeah. So, that thing can input way more power than I can possibly output, which is why it's not plugged into the MFSUs. However, I can still take these advanced solar panels and upgrade them to hybrid solar panels. Which, give me a moment to empty my inventory. I hate having a cluttered inventory. Okay, I think that's clear enough for now. So, let's see. What all do I need to make my advanced solar panels? Or, hybrid solar panels. Alright, I need carbon plate, lapis block, iridium plate. The advanced solar panel, that's easy. Advanced circuit. And the enriched scenarium, which means I need scenarium, which is UU matter plus glowstone dust. Well, got plenty of glowstone dust, and I have pretty decent amount of scenarium. I have 24, so divided by 6, that means I can make 3. I have a little bit of glowstone spare. And since I'm going to do as. Oops. Whoops. Well. Okay, so the assembly workbench doesn't work like I thought it would. Do I need power? Oh. Okay, so it's doing that auto. Sweet! Okay, I didn't know this worked for vanilla stuff. I didn't know this worked at all like this for the vanilla stuff. Wait, how did I end up with 4? Ah, 6 times 4 equals 24. Not 6 times 3, 6 times 4. Okay. Well, I know how I'm making overclockers now. That'll be easier. Alright, so that gave me my scenarium. Holy crap! That was right there! Yeesh. Apparently, rain's not good enough for this server. We have to have, like, exploding lightning. The lightning is. I've been noticing the lightning getting seriously worse on this server. I'm just glad fire spread isn't enabled. Anyways, to take my scenarium and turn it into whatever I need it to. What's it called that I need it to turn into? Enriched scenarium. I need. This stuff, the irradiant uranium, which I put some effort into making a little bit already. So just take that. Boop, boop, boop. I like this thing. It's not terribly fast, but still, I like this thing. I might have to break out this block here and put in another laser. Marriage scenarium, marriage scenarium. But why is it only doing everything in stacks of three? I don't know. Alright, so I have the expensive stuff, so I need advanced circuit, which means I actually need 8 of those, and I only have 6. Crap. Well, that'll make 8. I still need these. Which I need 8 of those too, right? Yeah, 8 carbon plates. I need my advanced alloy because I need to make iridium plates. I need some lapis. So, let's see, where do I hide lapis? I think lapis is way back here. Yes, right there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whoops. I keep forgetting to shift-click. Oh, well. Oh! I need lapis and glowstone and redstone for this anyways. Specifically, I need 4 of those. Redstone. 8 of those. Yeah, 4 of those. So first things first. Okay, you know what? I am just going to make another crafting bench. I've only gone through, I don't know, a dozen or so of these. They're all throughout the world. I have crafting benches everywhere. It's kind of ridiculous. Alright, that gives me the 8 I need. I need a crap ton more lapis blocks, don't I? Oy, what is wrong with me? Alright, so I have 8 enriched scenarium. I need my... probably all my iridium. I don't think I have enough iridium to make all 4. I got a spider chasing me. Yeah, I need 2 per solar panel, don't I? Yep, I do. Damn it! I can make 1 and that's it. What else do I need for that? A diamond! Crap. This stuff is not cheap. Okay, let's try this again. Oh. I need 2 diamonds. I must be tired or something. I don't know. And there's a spider chasing me, but he can't get at me. 2 diamonds. Which makes the 2 iridium plates. That means I didn't have to make those advanced circuits. Outside of that, I have everything except for the solar panel, which I need my electric wrench for. is going to take this one down here. He'll still be the odd man out. Okay, so advanced solar panel. Oh, right, I can do that. Wait. Oh, 8 ultimate hybrid solar panels, or 1 ultimate hybrid solar panel to make 8 hybrid solar panels. Okay. Clicky. And now I can see what I'm doing. So, one there. Advanced circuits, enriched sunrarium. And we have the ultimate, we have the hybrid solar panel. Adult has an ultimate hybrid solar panel already, which I'm not 100% sure what's needed to make that. Click. Hi, guy. This is why I have a fence. Anyways, we can see that it can output 128 max, and it's generating 8 EU per tick at night. I think during the day it will generate 64 EU per tick. Which I think still qualifies as low voltage. Uh, 128, on the other hand, does qualify as high voltage, or medium voltage, so be careful what you plug these things into. If it charges and starts outputting to a low voltage device, it will make that low voltage device explode. I still gotta do something with that. Let's do that today. I made this because I needed cactus to make the cactus green to make the waterproof pipe. Yeah. Almost automated cactus farm. I can make an automated cactus farm, I just don't feel like it. Yeah. Basically what I did... Alright. Basically, there's redstone that goes in a line from underneath this block the whole way down. And then for every piston, another line goes off in that direction. That way it actually connects to the piston. You can see the piston just under there. So the redstone will connect that way. If I put a redstone... block or chunk there, this would just square off and go that way and not actually connect to the piston, so it has to be separated like this. Whee. So let's put that stuff back. Yay. Alrighty. So let's see, if we want to make a mob grinder, where would we do it? Well, we can make it over here. There's a lot of space around here. Hi, chicken. Are you one of the ones that escaped earlier? Do you want back in? There you go. You can come in if you want. Or are you going to be like a cat where you just stand at the door and stare? Oy. Yeah, so there's plenty of space here. Even though it's kind of an eyesore to make it. But I guess I could always make it... I'm going to make it to show you guys how to make it. And then I'm going to... I'll cover it up, make it look like something else, I guess. Alright, first thing we need, a lot, and I mean a lot, of blocks. And the second thing we need is to figure out how water works, so I need a water bucket. How did I miss the door? Put some of this stuff away. Yeah, I know that's vanilla, not icy too, but whatever. Anyways, vanilla, water bucket. Should charge my drill. This is one thing I like about the advanced drill. It's charged. It charges that fast. I need to do that with the chainsaw. The chainsaw takes forever to charge. And now that I figured out how the advanced crafting table works, I'm totally going to. Alrighty. Where can I do these tests? Well, I guess I can make the base, the initial base, and start from there. So, let's guess. That looks good to me. How big is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Actually, I want them 8. 8 by 8. So, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, I know I'm covering up my mind, but I don't care. Click. Yeah, I don't exactly go into my mine all that often anymore, so I don't particularly care. There are also other places to go. Okay, now, the important thing that we want to see is that this water will reach from this block and go the entire way over to this block. Now, I made this quite small, so I don't think it'll be a problem. Oh yeah, it can go two more blocks. So, let's make this a little bigger. Because if we're going to be spawning zombies down here, in this area, I want as much space as physically possible to spawn the zombies. That way I can be as efficient as physically possible. And I'm not kidding when I said this thing's gonna be an eyesore. But that's okay. I'll work with it later. I don't know, I'll make it pretty somehow. Don't know how just yet. I'll figure it out. Now, I've got to admit, I learned how to do this from watching Silver. Bullseye. That'll work perfect. Alright, that'll do exactly what I want it to do. Except, in all honesty, I want it to do it the other way, so... How do I want to build this? Well, first let's build a big-ass box. You know what I'll do? While I'm building this, instead of fading to the next scene, I'll put on some music. And then you can listen to it while I'm building. And hopefully I set it up so you can still hear my voice, so I can still talk, so I don't have to interrupt the music. And this music, by the way, is from a friend of mine from my previous job. I will put his link in the description. I forget exactly where the link points now. It's been a long time since I've even bothered with that link, because I haven't used his music for a while. Okay, so now we have a big-ass box. And I want everything to go this way, so let's raise this floor up one block. Getting a lot of frames per second issue. Okay, it should work. Alright, where's another water supply? Right here, okay. Alright, now what I'm gonna do with the water is set it up. All of the water is going to push everything in this direction. Ah, see, I screwed up. Yep, I screwed up. This needs to be wider. Whoops. I didn't pick the best place to do this. No, I don't know why I'm doing that. Put those back because I was stupid to put them away. Frames per second issue. A lot of really big jumps. Now show me. Okay, now the goal of this is to get everything to fall down here and then get pushed this way. And then it will go through here. Push him out to this block right here. Yeah. Yeah, this'll work. So, now basically, a zombie will spawn somewhere in here. He'll get pushed, probably kicking and screaming, over this edge here. And then again, kicking and screaming, down here, to where he will stop here. Now, of course, from here, he can just hop out. But what we're going to do is going to be a little complicated. And I'm going to try to keep this all in my head. It's not going to be easy. What I need is a bunch of signs. And I pass my front door again. Oy. I don't have any wood. I do not have wood. Sounds like a personal problem. That should be enough for now. Oh, I should probably charge my drill again. Since it's nighttime, I should probably charge my sword. Sword takes a little bit longer to charge. But at least it's not too terribly long. I have the Battlestar Galactica theme stuck in my head. The new one, not the old Battlestar Galactica, the new Battlestar Galactica. The one where they made it edgy. Ooh. Oh, I could just do this. Put another one there. That. Another bucket of water. Okay. I seem to be lagging out a little bit. Alright, and what these signs will do is we'll keep the water there. Alright, in this just one block area, the water won't flow that way or down or, well, up. Obviously. Oh. Bloody lag. Somebody exploring the world. Specifically, somebody exploring the twilight. Well, this is just going to be an annoyance. Put the water there. Okay. Now what's happening is that the zombies will be spawned here, be forced down to this little trench right here, this trough type area, and then forced... Oh. Hang on, let me take off my jetpack so I can show this better. Of course, I'm not 100% sure if this will work. I might be wrong that this will work. They'll be forced down here. Be pushed this way. Yeah, and they won't necessarily be forced up, will they? Means I gotta put water on this block. I think I'm confused. I think I'm going to have to work out how this works. But generally what will happen, eventually what will happen, is they'll swim up and then get pushed along somewhere else. But I obviously have this planned out wrong. Hi, chicken. I've got really bad lag. Let's take off the quantum helmet. Maybe that'll help. Oh, it does, actually. Oh, it's gone funny. Let's make a quick infinite water supply. instant infinite water. And then let's rethink this design. I'm sure a lot of people are like, oh no, you idiot, you gotta do it this way. Well, I'm sure you do. I just don't know it, and I can't hear you screaming through the YouTubes. Wouldn't it be cool if I could? I guess that just means I gotta do a live stream someday. Pull it out one farther, will that work? If I let it flow out to here. Or if I leave it like that. A sign there. Bucket. Water there. Ah, we're not flowing water anymore. That's what I'm trying to fix. That's the problem. Yeah, if I push out one more. This. Let's put the water bucket there. Nope. Nope, I think I'm gonna have to float out one more. Alright, let's try that and find out. Here, and then they stop right here. Okay, I think I'm thinking about this too much. I'm getting overly complicated where I don't need to be. Like, the water stops here. It's just that I need to force them to stop here. Put something there. And yeah, put a water block there. Like, if I put a sign here. Put the water block there. Will that take care of the problem? Yeah, because then we get this goofy freaking water glitch, which pushes them into the water here. Okay, yeah, I got it. Here, a sign there, sign there, sign there. Get another bucket of water. There. And just continue this process further up. I'm not 100% sure exactly how high I need to go, so I'm going to be winging it. So this is what'll happen. Get off the jetpack real quick. They get pushed in here, and then being mobs, they naturally swim up. And then they keep swimming up until you get to where, well, to the next step, which I haven't built yet. Actually, I'm going to build the roof of this. That's 3 high. Let's build this 4 high. I guess I need to put up this wall. Okay, so now we have our enclosed box. So mobs will spawn in here, in this box, and then they will come up this port here. There, just make it even. Then we can make this higher, just basically by building a hole like this and putting a sign in it. And then just building another row on top and putting more water in it. And it's literally that simple. Yeah, that simple. I spent, 5 minutes trying to figure out why it wasn't working, why I couldn't get it to work. Again, I have no idea how tall this needs to be. Is that high enough to kill you? Thought I wasn't regenerating health here for a second. I'm sure I could Google exactly how high this needs to be. Of course, I could probably watch tutorial videos. I know people have done this particular design already. I learned this design from watching Silver make it. So it's kind of a common design. Kind of an obvious design. Okay, so is this high enough? I'm getting there. Ever so slowly. I'm gonna die building this thing. I am going to use all my signs, aren't I? So, heart and a half. Crap. I think I need to go one more higher. Well, that is me, isn't it? I think I'm a little more resilient than a zombie, so I guess we're going to have to find out the hard way. I think we're going to have to try. We're going to have to do trial and error. Alright, but the next goal we have to do, the next step, is get the zombies far enough out of the way we have to go 8 blocks out. So that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's find out. first off right there. Perfect. Okay. Here, make a hole. No, that's not a hole. That's the opposite of a hole. So once the zombies swim their way up this hole, they get pushed this way, and then they fall down this hole. And this is where they take damage. I'll make a chute for them to fall down so it's not just a random thing. I'm also going to close this off entirely. Since zombies are too tall, they only need this much space. Well, they need a little bit more space than that. Okay, yeah, and then basically they just start shooting out of that giant faucet. So that means the landing pad is right here. Probably gonna want a deeper nest. How much fun doing something like this would be in vanilla when you don't have a jetpack. Okay, this is not terribly easy with the jetpack. And then we can see the mobs right there. Alrighty. So, that's cool. Let's see how high is this. One more higher. Okay. Maybe one more higher than now, what that block is for, that block is to sit the spawner on top of. Which will go get the spawner. Which I will need my portal gun. Now, this will work in vanilla. It's just you have to build it around the spawner instead of building it and then putting the spawner in there. Because you can't do this in vanilla. Okay, it doesn't look that bad. It's not that much of an eyesore, at least. Ooh, and then we already got a zombie customer. Let's get out of here. Let's put up the cobble. Alright, basically what's happening, he's getting pushed down here into this little tube here, and then he's going up the tube. Down that tube, and then he'll fall here in a second. At least I'm fairly sure that's what's gonna happen. Yep, there he is. three, four. Four punch. So he's gotta fall farther. Oh, hey, there's a hole down here. I have dirt on me. I have a little bit of dirt on me. Okay. And hey, I can kill him. Without... If I want to make this a one-punch thing... Come on, zombies. Come and get me! Come on, guys! Fall further. Well, we're down to three punches. Oh, did he die? I think he died. I think he insta-died. Yeah, they're insta-dying. That's too low. Okay, apparently it's physically impossible to make a zombie grinder that is just one punch. Because right here, it takes me three punches. Three. But if I drop this one more... Insta-death. Alrighty then. Well, here is the kicker. I cannot make just a area, or just like, I can't put a piston here underneath this thing, so it will drop one block when I have this off and it will kill everything, because zombies spawn with armor. So what I want to do... is set it up so that this block gets pushed aside, like that way or that way, and then these guys fall a much, much greater distance. Yeah, like down here. And then any zombie with armor will just fall to his death. And then I can turn off the zombie grinder when I'm not using it. Hey, at least I can kill these guys fairly easily without turning on my nano sword. Boop. And now that's an instant death sentence to any zombie. Yep, there they go. What I can do is put an obsidian pipe down there, and then anything that dies there will get sucked up the obsidian pipe and put into, like, a chest. Which I will do that right now. How far down is this? Boop, 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 boop. that far down. And then, yeah, I'll just put, let's make damn sure. Put it there. Yeah, so any zombie that falls down dies here. On top of an obsidian pipe, the obsidian pipe goes this way. Takes its way up here into a chest. Right there. Wee thunk. So, obsidian pipe. Gold pipe, because now we know that gold pipes don't need a redstone signal to be active. Oh, I'm stuck. I'm still stuck. What the heck? Okay, and then I just need to put a chest right there. Come on, zombies, die and let me show off what I built. Come on, guys. Did you drop anything? Oh, there it goes. And everything just ends up in here. creativity. I love it. To activate it, we put a block there. And it's that simple. And now we have... Whoa, he died. Well, we have an almost perfect zombie grinder. We have a good enough zombie grinder. He died too. Why are they dying now? And I'm level 35. Alrighty. And then from here, all I have to do is just make it look pretty. And it's just that simple. Well, relatively simple. I guess simple is a relative concept, huh? I'm gonna have so much zombie flesh by the time I'm done with this. Looks like I need to make a canning machine. You know, while I was emptying out my inventory and charging up my stuff, it dawned on me that I don't think I ever pointed this trick out. I have an ender chest here, and I have an ender pouch here, and I use it to carry my really important stuff for in case I need it. The rock cutter with its silk touch, my drill, chainsaw, my two linking books, one to Black Mesa, one to Aperture Labs. And the reason I go to Adult's Place, the reason I have a book to Adult's Place, is because he links to the Central Nether Hub. I don't actually have a link to the Nether Hub. I probably should. I probably should just set up a link to the Nether Hub, be done with it. I want to make at least the beginning of the Maser Melter thing. So I need stone transport pipes, probably a lot of them. I'm gonna need wooden transport pipes, gold, I don't think I'm going to need diamond, but I am going to need the macerator and the electric furnace. That means I need glass fiber cabling, which is in here, and I don't have a lot of it. I don't think this is going to be enough to put things where I need to put them. Oh, I'm also going to need a lot of redstone engines, which I'll worry about shortly. I'm gonna put this. I guess I could put it over here. Do I have the room to put it over here? Kind of. Oh, there's another freaking grass block over there. No, I kind of don't. And I don't want the output chest being over there. It's too much cabling under here already. Don't want to add more to it. Alrighty. So then I will. Put the chest here. Oh, I can't because that's in the way. Gonna put the chest here. How am I gonna do this but still make it look pretty? I guess I could put the chest into the floor and then put the wooden pipe here. Guess that'll work. Let's put the gold pipe here. And then a bunch of that. Alright, I think I'm gonna do it like Adult has it, where he put the macerator pretty much directly attached to things, and then put the electric furnace directly underneath. See if I can get the wood pipes to connect like I want them to. No! Which means I either need a buildcraft wrench, which I think I have, or my electric wrench, which is IC2, which I also think I have. Probably be easier just to get the buildcraft wrench. God only knows where I left I haven't finished organizing my stuff yet. I've finished moving all my stuff out of this room into the new workshop. But that's my buildcraft wrench. Yeah, that thing's still going. Use the wrench to switch them around. You can always tell with Buildcraft which direction stuff is going, because the blocked off area, the opaque area, is where it's coming from, and the clear area is where it's going to. So this way we know it's coming out of the macerator into the Furnace. Okay, so redstone engines go on top here, and then I'm trying to build this in my head. It's not easy. Oh! Well, that was stupid of me. All right, it's obvious I'm not ready to build this thing yet. So I will save it for the next episode. I've already been recording for an hour and a half, so that's pretty good. I'll edit this down a little bit. We'll have a normal sized episode. I won't have a really long episode like I did last time. But hey, do what we can. Anyways, I'll work on the Macer Melter thing. Because I need parts. I need the upgrades for it, the transformer upgrades and the overclockers anyways, so I'll just take care of that. But anyways, I will see you guys next time, and as always, keep playing the game, and have fun.